In this video, I'm going to show you how to assess regional and segmental intervertebral motions of lumbar extension in prone lying position. Get our very own assessment ebook and mobile app. Links are in the video description. Hi and welcome back to Physiotutors. Passive assessment of the quantity and quality of segmental intervertebral motion, also known as motion palpation, is part of the diagnostic clinical expertise of manual practitioners to guide decisions on a therapeutic strategy for patients with spinal pain. Hypomobility indicates mobilizing interventions, while hypermobility calls for a stabilizing approach. A systematic review done by Van Treifel et al. In the year 2005 evaluated the reliability of passive segmental assessment of the lumbar spine and found an overall reliability of poor to fair. For this reason, the clinical value of passive lumbar spine assessment is weak. In order to perform regional range of motion assessment of lumbar spine extension of T12 till S1, have your patient in prone lying position and stand on a side to be examined. Then fixate your patient's spinous process of T12 in ventrocaudal direction. Grab onto the contralateral leg above the knee joint from the inside and bring the hip into its maximally closed peg position of internal rotation, adduction and extension. Now perform a homonymous 3D movement with equal components of extension, ipsilateral, lateral flexion and ipsilateral rotation by bringing the hip further into extension and adduction until your finger wants to move. This movement causes maximal compression of the facet joints on the side you are standing at. The whole movement is judged on resistance during motion and at end range, range of motion as well as possible pain provocation. In order to assess segmental movement between, say, L2 and L3, fixate your patient's spinous process of L2 into ventrocaudal direction. Then again, grab onto the contralateral leg above the knee joint from the inside and bring the hip into its maximally closed peg position of internal rotation, adduction and extension. Now perform a homonymous 3D movement with equal components of extension, ipsilateral, lateral flexion, and ipsilateral rotation by bringing the hip further into extension and adduction until you feel that your fixating hand wants to move. In order to test each component of intervertebral motion, slightly move out of the end range and now test extension between L2 and L3 by pushing the spinous process of L2 ventrocaudally. To assess the rotation component, move to the contralateral arch of L3 and push it ventrally. And for the lateral flexion component, put your thumb between spinous processes of L2 and L3 and perform lateral flexion by moving the hip further into adduction. Each component is judged on resistance during motion and at end range and feel, as well as possible pain provocation compared to the segment above or below. Okay, this marks the end of our video. If you want to know how to assess intervertebral motion assessment of lumbar extension in sitting position, click on the video right next to me. Thank you very much for watching. Feel free to give this video a like and share it if you liked it. And if you want to see more of us, check us out on other social media channels. And for all of our videos, including articles, statistical values, and more, have a look at our very own assessment ebook and app. Links can be found in the description down below. This was Kai for Physiotutors. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.